Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. And for those who are new, I'm Rhythm. Today's video is going to be about creating this office work makeup look. If you think you're interested, stay tuned. Please don't forget to hit the like button and please subscribe to my channel. With all that being said, let's jump right into the video. I've already put back my hair using this beautiful hairband which I absolutely love. And now for foundation, I'm going to use this Milani Conceal and Perfect 2-in-1 Foundation Concealer. I'm in the shade number 5, Warm Beige. And why I love this foundation, because it claims to be also doing the job of a concealer. And in the morning when you're getting ready for work, who has the time to go through the extra step of highlighting and concealing? So that is exactly why I absolutely love this. So basically, I've taken out the foundation over here, and now I'm going to lightly dab it on my face in a dabbing motion, like so. I've already primed my face, and in the morning, if you forget to prime your face, you can always use a good moisturizer. And this claims to be a full coverage foundation, and that is why I absolutely love it. Also, the color matches pretty good for me. Since you're always in a bit of a hurry in the morning for your office, you don't want a very time-consuming routine for your makeup. So as you can see, I've already put the foundation all over my face. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my finger and dab the remaining foundation underneath my eyes, since I'm not going for an extra concealer. And you can use your finger to blend or the same brush. I'm going to use my all-time favorite, my PAC concealer brush, and I'm going to lightly dab it under my eye. In the morning, all of us are in a bit of a rush, so foundation is the way to go, guys. Don't skip this step, because a good base will always make you look presentable. And that's it. So as you all saw, I just used the foundation to cover all the unevenness, any pigmentation, and anyways, it's an office look, guys. I don't have to be like perfect. At the end of the day, I just want to look presentable, so I'm really not too keen on like a heavy coverage, and that is why I just used one foundation. And if you're in a hurry, this foundation is a must try. And now what I'm gonna do is, I'm just going to set my unrest so that it doesn't crease. I'm going to use this fixing powder from Krylon. And this is a translucent powder, very finely milled. You can actually set your under eye and also your entire face. I'm going to quickly take this sponge, and I'm just going to push the product in under my eye, like this. And also on my lids, since I have very oily eyelids. Guys, who has the time to do cream contouring early in the morning, for God's sake? You can use any powder to contour and bronze your face, and for that I'm going to use this Hoola from Benefit. It's a very popular product, of course everybody knows. And I'm going to use the brush that comes along. It's a very good brush. Also for nose contouring, it works very well. And I'm going to dab up the excess, and I'm going to bronze with this Hoola Benefit bronzer. It's a very good shade, actually. I don't know how it manages to suit all the skin tone. That's amazing. And if you have only 5 seconds extra in your morning routine, you can just contour your nose using the same brush. You don't have to use an extra brush. And that's it, guys. The next thing what we are going to do is use a blush. I'm using this blush by The Balm Cosmetics. I love this blush. It's such a cute color and also very natural looking color. More on the earthy peachy tone. So I absolutely love shades for blushes that have a peach undertone. I'm going to use a Morphe brush. I'm going to take the product, dab up the excess, smile a bit, and I'm going to put the blush on the apples of my cheeks. I personally love matte blush on, especially for work or office, because I prefer having less shimmer on the face, especially for an office look. Now what what I'm going to do is I'm going to take any brush. I'm just dabbing off the excess powder that I use to set my under eye. And after that, I'm going to set my face with a fixing spray, because for an office or work look, you want your makeup to stay put. And for that, I'm going to use the spray from Morphe. It's a very good setting spray, but also the one from MAC. The Fix Plus is amazing. God, it's so refreshing. You want to take a bath in it. So meanwhile, the sets, you can do your brows. I'm using this brow definer from Anastasia. I'm so waiting for Anastasia to launch in India, guys. They have such amazing products. And as I told you, I always used to think that Indians don't really need brow products, as we tend to have quite fuller brows. Believe me, once you get in the habit of doing brows, you feel that you were so wrong, and it gives you such a complete finished look. And the shade is dark brown. It's a perfect match for me. So if you can see, this looks way more defined. And now I absolutely love doing brows now. I'm just going to make the shape of my brow. And I'm very lightly going to fill in the sparse areas where probably my threading lady goofed up, or probably the areas where I have very less growth. Guys, the brows are done and it looks so much neater and presentable. Now for eyes, I'm going to use this palette, Soft Clamp from Anastasia. Love, love, love this palette. This is such an amazing palette, guys. I want to show you. It comes with a mirror like so, and also it has some beautiful matte shades right over here, and the shimmer shades for your glam look. And if you have somebody coming from abroad, please request them to get it for you. You are so going to love this palette. And this palette comes with a brush like so, a dual-ended brush, and it is so usable. So now for my eyes, because I don't want a very flat looking eyes and I want to add some depth to the eye, I'm going to use a probably burnt orange and rustic, like going back and forth like so. And I'm going to apply it on the crease area. Just done with the excess. And I'm just placing the brush right over here and taking back and forth motion. I'm going to blend the colors over there. I don't want to add a pop of color, but I just want to add some depth to my eye. And I'm just going to drag the products so that I have a bit of a shape. I'm not adding any more color, just blending whatever I added. Doing the same on the other eye, taking burnt orange, bit of rustic, tapping off the excess, placing on the crease, and then going with the back and forth motion. If you don't have this palette, you can just go for any neutral brown which has a tint of an orange, like more on the yellow side, and that should also do the same trick. So after blending, it should look like this. And now what I'm gonna do it, and to have a more open eye effect and a more brighter look, I'm going to use another matte shadow from this Huda Beauty Matte & Metals. They have a shimmer on one side and they have matte on one side, and I absolutely love this color. This is in the shade 44, and it's such a nice pigmented color, and yet it gives an amazing open eye effect. So I'm going to very lightly dab it on the inner corner right over here. It's such a pigmented product that you want to really go easy, and I'm just going to use my finger and probably try blending this. I absolutely love this shade. Also, sometimes I use to do a cut crease, and it blends so beautifully. It also acts as a primer. So guys, that's how it looks. See, it instantly gives that open eye effect much more brighter. And now what we're going to do is I'm just going to take this black eyeshadow and put it on my lash area so that I don't have any gaps. And also, sometimes you're too lazy to put an eyeliner. I'm just going to fill in using a flat brush, and I'm just going to smoke out the edges. Like this. I'm not putting the shadow on the entire lash area, but I'm just dragging whatever product I have left like so. So if you see, this black is not like a really jet black. It came out to be very soft, like a more of the gray look. And now we're going to add mascara. I'm going to use my current obsession, the Lash Warrior from Flower Beauty. Now after mascara, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the same shade, the burnt orange, and I'm going to very lightly take this, and since I'm not going for a very heavy coal line looks, I'm going to drag this on under my eye. So guys, if you don't have time to put kajal or kohl on your lower lash line, you can always take an eyeshadow and place it under your lash line, because then it gives such a complete look. And I'm also going to put mascara on my lower lash line. So guys, I did put on some lashes, and of course that's totally optional. But for work, if you put on some lashes, if you're confident, it looks much more attractive. And after lashes, I'm just going to use a teeny tiny bit of a highlighter so that I don't have a very flat effect on the face, because a highlighter adds a bit of a sheen and a dimension. And to highlight my face, I'm going to use the Soft and Gentle by MAC. It's one of those highlighters which everybody had back in the days, and it's such a subtle highlighter. The best part is you don't have that shimmer or the glitter particles in it, so you can wear it to your office because it gives that very subtle glow. And I'm going to take my finger, rub it in, and then very lightly I'm going to put it on the center of my nose. Nothing too harsh, but very gentle, as the name says. And I'm going to lightly dab it over here and here as well. And that's it, guys. I don't want to add too much of shimmer for my office look, so that's all. And for lips, I'm going to show you two different options. One is an absolute matte and the other one is a Nykaa. This also settles down to a bit of a matte, but for those who are not absolutely the pure matte lovers, they can opt for this lip color. This is in the shade Nefertiti and it's easily available. So this is the first shade, and this is Nefertiti from Nykaa, and the other shade I'm going to try is this from Smashbox. It's my favorite shade, called Driver's Seat. I love wearing earthy browns, corals to work. This is the shade Driver's Seat. You can totally go for this color in case you can carry mattes. Absolutely love this color. So alright you guys, that was it. That was my work look, office look. I just tied my hair in a sling back ponytail, popped on some earrings, and that's it. So if you are in a hurry early in the morning, you can always skip the step of a concealer. As you all see that if you use a full coverage foundation, you can manage your way out and create a nice flawless look, which also looks very effortless in the morning. And that's it guys. If you like my video, please don't forget to hit the like button. Please subscribe if you like my video. If there are any suggestions, feedbacks, requests for the videos, please let me know in the comment section below. Hope to see you in my next video. Bye.